The answer here is that all of these six factors can influence the running time of an algorithm. So the size of the input, I think that's a rather obvious one. So in the example of Alice, if she's running her algorithm on a very small network, that takes much shorter time than if she's running it on the huge 500 communication center network, for example. The structure of the input can also influence the running time of an algorithm. So, for example, if the network was structured in a way that we find that it can be covered with one or two monitoring devices, then the algorithm could work in a way that we could immediately stop and not need to look at more complex assignments. Finally, the type of computer that we're using, that is also a very obvious one. If you're using a computer that is much faster, so say we're using a huge workstation instead of a simple laptop, then the algorithm will run much faster. The amount of memory the computer has, that can also be a very important factor, although it might not be obvious at first sight what memory has to do with running time. But say the memory of your computer is not enough to keep all the data that the algorithm is using, and it has to use the hard disk, for example, to do some of the work, or the memory is not enough and the algorithm has to recalculate certain parts of the solution. So memory is also an important factor for running time. How the algorithm is implemented, that is of course very important. So are you using an implementation that is very efficient, or do you have any unnecessary code or any data structures that are inefficient? That can make a huge difference in the practice when you run an algorithm. And finally, the programming language used, that is of course a debate that many people like to have, but it's certainly a factor. So there are some programming languages that will make an algorithm run a lot faster than other programming languages. And so you need to think about if efficiency matters, you'll usually also use a programming language that is suited for that. That's quite a lot of factors to look at. And actually, I think there are lots of other factors that will also determine the running time of an algorithm. So that's why when we talk about analyzing algorithms, we'll have to work with a number of simplifications to focus on what's really important and not have to take account of all these factors and all the countless others that you might think of.